Hey folks, Matt from ArtOfTheImage.com. We've got a viewer writing in on the email. This is Paul. He's writing in. The title of the email is First Full-Frame Camera Question. He says, hi Matt, I love all your content and enjoy watching all your videos and tips about cameras. Thank you. I'm looking to buy a new full-frame camera and I'm trying to figure out which one to buy. I have only been doing photography for about 6 months, but I'm going to Europe and want to get a better quality full-frame camera for my trip. I do not shoot video at all and more like cityscape, night shooting, and landscape photography. Maybe video is something I can get into, but I doubt it. My range is $1,500 and I don't know whether to get a Nikon D7500 or something less expensive and maybe buy it used and then get a good lens to go with it. Maybe a wide angle. Would you have any suggestions for the lens as well? I do not care whether I go Nikon or Canon. Any suggestions are welcome. Thanks so much for your time, and I look forward to hearing from you. Happy holidays. Well, thank you, Paul. Good question. And one that I think a lot of people struggle with when they're looking at going into a full-frame system, if you're already in a camera system, which it doesn't sound like you are, even if you are, a lot of the lenses you're going to have to get rid of from your crop sensor lenses anyway, so unless you've been buying ones that are usable on full frame. In other words, you've been buying full frame lenses. So, $1,500. You did say the Nikon D7500. I think that was maybe just a typo. I think you meant the D750 because the D7500 is a crop sensor camera. It's a DX, and the 750 is a very nice Nikon full frame. So if you want lenses as well, see, that's what I'm not sure if your $1,500 is your budget total or if that includes your lenses. So the 750 is probably going to be fill up your budget just on itself. The 610 you'd be able to get with a lens. So that would probably be my number one suggestion. I guess I just came right out and said it there, didn't I? The Nikon D610, it's a beautiful camera. If you buy it used or refurbed, you could probably get refurbed from Nikon, which is why I like to buy things that way, because they're factory refurbs. So they've come off the line, something was out of spec, a technician dials it in, it's great. I've had lots of luck with that type of purchase. The 610 with the 24-120 f4 VR would be the way to go. I love that lens. It's a very good lens. It's got a good range. It's f4, so it's not an f2.8 zoom, but it is a constant f4. So it's very sharp, very good performing. It's a constant aperture f4, so it's still pretty quick. And the D610 is a very good low-light camera. I think you should be able to get that for $1,500. Probably refurbed, maybe even new on sale. Definitely used if you shopped around for a good used set. The other option to go is a D610 new with the 24-85. It's a decent lens. It's not as good as the 24-120. It doesn't have quite the range, and I'd say it's not quite as sharp, quite as good a performer, but still very decent. I've used it. I've shot it for reviews and when I've had the 610 here, and I like it. So that's an option too. The D750, if you could pick it up refurbed or used and then save money that way and then maybe get the 24-85 lens. I mean, essentially, the awesome kit there to go together is the D750, a 24-120 for your standard lens. If you want a wide angle, there's wide angles available, but you probably don't need one with a 24-120 unless you really need an ultra wide. I'd throw in an 85 f1.8 for me as a portrait lens, and that would be pretty much all I need for coverage. And then if you want longer coverage, the 70-300 VR from Nikon is a really nice lens, which you could use with any of the full frame, the 610 or the 750 or whatever you were going to buy. So those are a couple of options. Obviously, the less expensive way to go is the D610. But the 750, the big advantage is a little beefier body in the sense of a little more rugged, although the 610 I've never had any problems with. But a better autofocus system is basically the big difference in the 750. Plus, you got the flip-up screen on the 750. But the D610 has a good autofocus system, but not as good as the 750s. The 750, when it came out, had the flagship Nikon autofocus system. So very good autofocus system in the 610, excellent autofocus system in the 750. So you're paying a bit more for that and the ruggedness, the little higher grade body. So Those are the differences, and then it just depends what your pocketbook can handle. I personally would have no problem shooting a pair of 610s for weddings and events and whatnot. I really like that system. Talked about that before. Now, on the Canon side, what would you go with? Well, a 6D, an original 6D, might be a good value right now, whether it's used or refurbed or even new on sale. The new 6D Mark II, if you can get a good deal on it, would probably, though, I'm thinking, still be outside of your budget, unless you bought it used. So one of those two, whatever fits your budget. And then the 24-105L, even if you buy the version 1, it's still a very good lens. That might save you some money that way. The version 2 is a very good lens too, just not, you won't get it as inexpensively. I'd do the same thing there if I was going that route. I'd get one of those two, and I would get the 85 f1.8 from Canon. Very nice portrait lens. And then you've also got some options for what length of long zooms you want to add to that. So I would go with either of those two options for your budget. Me, what I would do would be the 610 and the 24-120. If I could afford it, if your budget fits it, and it's not just your, that's not your total budget for $1,500, I would get the 750 and the 24-120 F4 VR. That's the route I would go. Not to say there's anything wrong with the Canons, I just prefer those two Nikon bodies over the 6D and the 6D Mark II. But let me throw it back to you guys. What would you guys do? Do you agree with me? Would you get a 610 or a 750 if budget allows? Would you go with the Canons? What would you do and why? Let's hear your comments below. Leave them in the comments below. Help out Paul. It's always helpful, I find, to get a few different opinions. Helps you think out your purchase strategy, what you're going to do and why. And then also, I would always throw in, too, get into the store, get them both in your hands, and see what you think of the cameras in hand, too, because that can really influence your decision, too. You may find you can't stand the Nikon system, or you can't stand the Canon system, or you really, really like one over the other. And it's not that you don't like the other one, but you like one more than the other for certain reasons. So get them in your hands. Looking forward to hearing what you guys have to say. Let's help Paul out. Comments below. And thanks for your question, Paul. Stay tuned. We'll be back soon here at artoftheimage.com.